This tiny teach is going to be about ATP accounting. I want to go through how many ATP molecules we made for one molecule of glucose in cellular respiration or aerobic energy production. In glycolysis, we produce two molecules of ATP and two NADH. The bridge between glycolysis and the Krebs cycle, we made two NADH. The Krebs cycle, we made two ATP, six NADH, and two FADH2. So far between glycolysis and the Krebs cycle, we have four ATP total. All of the electron carriers are going to feed into the electron transport chain. We're going to have 10 NADH that are going to feed in, and we're going to have two FADH2 that are going to feed in. For each NADH that feeds in, we're going to produce three ATP. For each FADH2 that feeds in, we're going to produce two ATP. The reason we get less ATP for each FADH2 is because FADH2 drops its electrons off farther down the electron transport chain. For more information on that, listen to my Tiny Teach on my YouTube channel. So if we do the math, 10 NADH at 3 ATPs each is 30 ATP. 2 FADH2 times 2 ATP is 4. So from the electron transport chain, we're going to get 34 ATP. Plus 2 from glycolysis, 2 from the Krebs cycle, is 38 ATP total from our one molecule of glucose. This is what prokaryotes get from one molecule of glucose. Eukaryotes only get 36 because they do a change in venue. Because they do the Krebs cycle and the electron transport chain in the mitochondria, it takes energy to move into that organelle. So one molecule of glucose for them only yields 36 molecules of ATP.